Maharaj told that name of this place is Ritu Dweep. Why Ritu Dweep? Because all the six Ritu, Ritu means season. Six seasons are there in a year. All the six seasons, all the six Ritus, they did Aradhana of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu here. And they got benediction from Mahaprabhu. As well as at this place, Basant Ritu, which is king of all the six Ritus, all the six reasons always reside here. This place gives stimulation of Braj. When Nityanand Prabhu was here, he was crying for Krishna. His heart was filled with the feeling of Balram, and he was saying, Kanhai, Kanhai, where have you gone? Maharaj was explaining that deer, all the trees and everything over here was giving him stimulation of Braj. So he was crying for Krishna. There is a kund. This place is hidden Radha kund. So it gives us all the thought of Braj. Not only Braj, the topmost place in Braj is Radha kund. Then Maharaj was explaining very wonderful thing, that this place is topmost in all the three loka. What are three lok? One is this Mrityu lok, second is Vaikunth lok, and third is Golok. And this place is superior most from all these three loks. Why? Maharaj said that what to speak of this Mrityu lok. Mrityu lok means this material world. This material world we should not talk about. Even Vaikunth lok does worshipping at the lotus feet of Golok Vrindavan. And then he was explaining millions and trillions of Vaikunth lok cannot be put on the similar ground of Dwarka. Dwarka is so high that even trillions of Vaikunth cannot be matched. Why? Then Maharaj explained that once in Dwarka, because in Dwarka, Krishna is having Leela with his 16,108 wives and many children. Once he was sitting on a palang. Palang means? Cot. Not cot, decorated cot, palang. And Rukmani was fanning him. At that time Krishna said, Oh Rukmani, I did very big mistake by marrying you. And you also did the same. I am no match for you, because you are daughter of a king. You are really a Rajkumari queen. And I am of no any high dynasty. I am not son of a king. And you are a queen. So there is not good match. Even very many demigods and rich people like Shishupal wanted to marry you. But instead of marrying them, you got married to me. It is very bad. You know, many rich people wanted to marry you and poor people used to come to me. I am said to be God of poor people. I am black. I have no match with you. So it is very unfortunate for on your part that you got married to me. I now give you open offer. You select any person and I will get you married to him. And I have no any objection. I leave you free. When Krishna was talking like this, at that time Rukmani started fainting. She fell down like a cut tree. And then Krishna became very much perturbed. Then he started fanning from his pitambar. And he said, Rukmani, why you got fainted? I was just doing joke, parihas. I thought that you will be rejoicing my mood. Instead of rejoicing, you became so sad. In Braj, I used to do every day. And same I did here. You know, we are grahast. When we come from outside, husband comes from outside with toilsome labor. He comes in his family with his children and wife. He does some this nok jok. You know, fighting, nagging. And by this fighting, nagging and jolly talks, he rejoices. Otherwise, life will become hell. in Braj, I used to speak such lies so many times. And gopis used to say, you are dhurt, you are lampat. And I used to enjoy it. But you fainted. Maharaj was giving the difference that what is happening in Dwarka and what is happening in Braj. So Krishna is giving the difference. Then Rukmani got up. She got relieved. She said, yes, you are right when you are saying. I am still in three guna. Tamagun, Rajagun and Satagun. I am still in three guna and you are guna atit. You are beyond these three guna. So there is no match with me and you. She said, you are king of Vaikuntha and these people are only materially rich people. So they are not related to you at all. So of course I am not a match for you. But still I request you that in lives and lives together, may I become your just maid servant. I will do all services to you. But please, I request with folded hand, don't take me out from your heart. So this was the request of Rukmani. Maharaj was explaining. That it is said in Upadeshamrita that the highest place in Braj is also Radha Kund. Vrindavan is superior to Mathura. Why? Because Ras Leela took place there. There is Seva Kunj. Because of these places and many other places, Vrindavan is far, far better than Mathura. But Maharaj was explaining, if we compare it with Radha Kund, Vrindavan is not equivalent to the glow of feet of Radha Kund's toe. Glow of feet of Radha Kund's toe. And Vrindavan is not equivalent to even that. Why? Because in Radha Kund, such leelas take place where no foreign, opposite and external element was there. Free meeting of Radha and Krishna. One thing more, ek cheez aur. The important thing then Maharaj was saying that once Prabhupada was saying that in 24 years I was doing parikrama of Braj. I have just tried to annul Mayavad and many other things. But my main motto is that I want to give all of my devotees Braj Bhav. And you should gain it. Even in 25 years, if you don't gain it, then it is all useless. When you are coming to and associating with an advanced devotee for 10 years, 15 years, 20 years and 25 years, a slightest desire and greed does not come for this Braj Bhav, then there is no glorification of association with Rasik Bhakta. So the glorification of Rasik Bhakta is that when we associate with him for a while only, this greed comes. So Maharaj was stressing that this greed should come in us. And we should carve for it. God Premanande Hari Hari Bhava.